God, how did this go? اقتلوهم حيث ثقفتموهم وأخرجوهم من حيث أخرج. Fight them where you see them. You kill them on the spot. Kill them, massacre them, throw them out of their homes, whatever. So what happens is the non-Muslims take this verse out of context. Look at even Islamis. The verse does say, kill them wherever you find them, son. Wherever you find them, kill them. And then they use it out of context. But look when, in the 6th year of Hijrah, after for 13 years they were being persecuted, killed, everything. Then they leave their homes 6 years after Hijrah. 13 plus 6 is 19 years later. They are told, fight back now, because now they're going to continue, there's going to be no Islam. Now fight back. And when they fight you, you exterminate. Look at the context of how it was reviewed. 19 years later, you're just defending, you're defending, you're running away, you're leaving your home. 19 years later, see now, if they come to you, you don't hold back any longer. Look how people use the verse out of context. And that's the importance of context. So here it is, udina, it is given permission, lilladina, to those who yuqatalun, have been fought. Or have, this is in the mudari verb, or will be fought. Bi'annahum, because they were dhulimu, they were wronged. Okay? So this is something important on the context of the name. Wa inna Allah, and indeed Allah ala nasrihim, in relation to helping them, la indeed qadir, very much able to do so, very capable. And who are these people that were wronged? Alladina, those who ukhriju, they were taken out of their home. So akhraja, and then ukhriju. Akhraja, yukhriju, ukhriju. And then ukhriju, this is another majhoob. They have been expelled, they have been exiled, they have been taken min diyarihim, from their homes. Bighayri, without haq, any right. So it was undue against them that they were taken out. Illa, except ayyakulu, that they said, Rabbun Allah, our Lord, so the only reason why they were fought is because they said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. They said, I believe in Allah. And people hated that so much that they were willing to fight him, willing to kill him, willing to drive him out of the home. SubhanAllah. Walawla, and were it not, Daf'ullahi, Allah pushing annas, people, Allah subhanAllah pushing people, meaning using people, ba'dahum, some of them, bi-ba'din, with others, some of them with others, or some of them against others, la-huddimat, would have been destroyed, sawami'u. Sawami'u is the monasteries. Now this is speaking about things of the past, where people of different religions were on the right religion. So for example, the people that Nabi Isa was sent to were Christians, but they believed, the correct belief was that Nabi Isa is a prophet and we believe in Allah. So we talk about the Ahlul Kitab, those who believed in Allah and the correct. So monasteries firstly, and then Bi'un is churches. Well, salawatun is synagogues. I'll explain now quickly why the word salawat seems very similar to one of our words. We're speaking about synagogues. And then masajid, the masajid. And what about these places? Yudhkaru fiha smullah. Allah's name, yudhkaru fiha, is mentioned in it kathiran, a lot. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah uses people against other people to ensure that there's peace. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't have the system, meaning that 19 years later Allah has given permission to the Muslims now fight back, then past generations, if Allah didn't use one against the other to create this peace, then the places of worship of the past where people were worshipping Allah would have already been destroyed. David and Goliath, Dawud and Jalut. It was Dawud was very small. You know the story. He comes to a giant. They are very small, few people. And you know, according to the story, he uses a catapult and he's able to overcome a giant. But this giant wants to create havoc in the world. So had Allah not used Dawud in that case, then what would have happened? He would have done what he wanted to do. If he doesn't believe in Allah, he doesn't believe in Islam, he doesn't believe in anyone worshipping other than what he believes. Fir'aun says, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I'm your Lord, the Most High. So anything else I'm going to destroy. He decided that every second year I'm going to kill all the males that will give me birth. So they could do what they wanted to do when they wanted to do, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses people to ensure that Islam continues. And in this we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses us, you know, to ensure that Islam continues. You know, plant the seed. Plant the seed within your children, plant the seed wherever you can, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue using us for this deen. وَلَا يَنْصُرَنَّ. And this verb over here has two forms of emphasis. The la of emphasis, la bitawqeed, and the noon, التوكيد, التقيل, the heavy emphatic noon. La wa la yansuranna Allah. Allah will most definitely help by yansuruhu. This is something very interesting. Allah says the literal meaning of it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will most definitely help those who helped him. Now, can you help Allah? Can you help Allah? Is it possible to help Allah? Okay. But can you help Allah? Five minutes left, inshallah, we will conclude.
By his permission.
Sorry?
Can help by his permission.
Okay, but Allah says about himself, number one, Qul huwa Allahu ahad, Allahu samad. The word samad is a very powerful meaning. It says that everything and everyone is dependent on Allah, and Allah is dependent on none. Understand? So what the beauty of this word is, number one, so you when you assist the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the beauty of it is that when you're assisting the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah regards it in such a high regard, it's as if you're assisting Allah. You can't assist Allah. You cannot assist, we can't assist Allah. Allah is the doer. Innama arada, innama. I don't know what's going on. Innama amruhu. Iza arada shay'an, ayyakula lahu, kun fayakul. Allah is such that if He wants anything to happen at any point in time, the only thing He needs to do is say, "Kun bi fayakun and will be." And this is the extent of Allah's power. But Allah created this world with cause and effect, you know, and He wants to see those who are going to make effort, so He can reward them for the effort. But Allah regards the one who makes effort for this deen so much; He regards it so high. That when you do assist this deen, it's as if you're helping Allah. You're helping somebody that can't and doesn't need help, but it's regarded in that light. This is big. Something that can't be done, Allah puts you on that rank. That you help this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you're directly helping Allah, and we've just established that you can't help Allah. But the reward and the likeliness of helping this deen and assisting this deen of Allah is that you get the reward of that. Inna Allah, and there Allah ends the verse. Inna Allah, la indeed, qawi, he's the one that's strong. You can't actually help Allah. But you will be put on that rank as if you were helping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Aziz, the Mighty. Okay. Our time is up. Conclude on that note. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept of us, inshallah. We started off with the intention that nothing reaches Allah except the purity of the intention, the taqwa behind it. And then, yeah, we ended off that you will be put on the rank as if you are helping Allah by helping the deen of Allah. So make the niyyah. Make the niyyah. When you make a niyyah, it's already recorded as a good deed. And then when you execute the niyyah, it's multiplied by 10 to 700 times. So make the niyyah. Whatever capacity you are able to facilitate this deed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then do so. And everyone's capacity is different. Everyone's going to have a different capacity, different ability, different way. But make the niyyah. All of us must do it. Oh yes, the salawat. So the word. Okay, I got 2 minutes. So the word salawat and masajid, both words over here. Number one, the word masjid. It's close to home. It comes from the word sajida. So masjid is the place of when you make sujood. Sajida, masjid, maf'il. It's the place of the action. So salawat, what happened in salawat is salutations. And in this word over here, synagogue, it's like praises and salutations. At that time, this is what was happening in that particular place. The synagogue was praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being made. Salutations were sent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the word over here, salawat, is making a reference to synagogues. Because it's talking about the place where those actions were being made. Understood? خير جزاك الله خير وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.